Radharani is not daunted. Radharani is an ordinary woman like we are, our wife, our sister, our mother. No. She is the planner for heaven. And the birth of Radharani was not from the womb of any human being. She was found by her father in the field while his father was plowing. He saw one little nice child is lying there, and he had no children, so he got it and presented to the queen. Oh, yeah, we have got a very nice child. How you gone, huh, in the field? Yes, Radharani's Janma is like that. So this Janma is today, and Radha, this name, is sometimes not found in Bhagavad. So, the atheistic class of men protest that Radharani's name is not in the Srimad Bhagavatam. How this name came, Radharani? But they do not know how to see it. There is Anayana Radharate. There are many gopis, but there is mention that by this particular gopi, he is served more pleasingly. Krishna accepts this gopi service more gladly. Anaradate, aradate. This aradate, this word, aradate means worshipping. From this word, aradate, Radha has come. But Radha's name are there in other Puranas. This is the origin. Radha and Krishna. Krishna is enjoyer, and he wants to enjoy. So he is the supreme Brahma, that he cannot enjoy anything. Atmana, he can enjoy in himself. Therefore, Radharani is the expansion of his pleasure potential. Krishna hasn't got to sit external things for his pleasure. No. He is in himself full. Atmana. So, Radharani is expansion of Krishna. Krishna is the energetic and Radharani is the energy. Just like energy and energetic, you cannot separate. Fire and the heat, you cannot separate. So, wherever there is fire, there is heat. And wherever there is heat, there is fire. Similarly, wherever there is Krishna, there is Radha. And wherever there is Radha, there is Krishna. They are inseparable. But he is enjoying